Good morning, Titans. This is Brendan.
This is Maddie.
And we are here to welcome you to a wonderful February 21st. This is Titan Talk. It is partly cloudy. It is a high of 39, and it is National Cherry Pie Day.
I love pie. Do you like pie?
I love pie. And you know who else loves pie? Elliot Miller. Come on in for birthdays. So, birthday pie.
Hola, bienvenidos a los cumpleaños. Feliz cumpleaños a Joshua Garlic, Aaron DePro, Andrew Bohe, Scott Laura, Lizzie Andrews, Abraham Yerba, Sean Cosgrove, and Aubrey Aponik. Feliz cumpleaños, amigos. Adios.
Hi, thank you, Elliot.
Thank you.
And now, sports with Casey.
No pie there.
Congrats to all the people who made all of the spring sports teams. And next Tuesday, on the 25th, there's going to be a high school golf club interest meeting. Awesome.
That's Casey.
Thank you, Casey. The Junior High Dance is tonight from 6:30 to 8:30.
Yes.
We hope everyone bought their tickets. Remember, we have a school celebrity showing up, and I hope that everyone has a great time tonight at the dance. College Apparel Day is today for all high schoolers. You can show off your dream school, the school you're going to, your school that you like the colors for, all options, except you must have uniform models.
Yes, and even if it's a college you just like the mascot of, I love Phoenix Online University because of their phoenix.
And Spirit Day is next Friday, so that's when everyone can wear their spirit shirts that show off their school, and as always, uniform bottoms.
Yes,
and
uniform bottoms.
The Winter Athletics Award Ceremony is February 27th at 6 p.m. So all sports players in the winter, be sure to put that on your calendars and get all those awards that you've worked so hard for.
Yes, we'll be looking out for that. All right, Titans, in clubs and other news, Titans, high school, I'm looking at you. March Madness, that is the event, the last day of the quarter, and is going to culminate into an awesome, epic Class B Class Basketball Cup. So if you liked the energy of the pep rally and you love basketball, then this is the event for you. Also, Operation Prom Princess, or OPP, Student Council will be collecting dresses, shoes, jewelry, and new makeup, and offering service hours to those who bring it in. For more information, talk to Mrs. Overacker about that. And lastly, we have the Powder Puff Game. That is for high school only too. And it is Friday, May 8th, next quarter at 6 p.m. And it's gonna be a roles reverse football game. So if you love football and you wanna have a little fun with your fellow high school peers, then come on out, Titans. It's gonna be an awesome time.
And now, I think it's time for the club showcase.
Is it already? Yes!
So, I'm Dylan.
Bree.
I'm Connor.
And we are some of the leaders of Creative Writing Club, and our club is basically getting a bunch of students to read, write, and draw a lot of things that they're interested in about the genres and books that they love, and a lot of things that they are interested in, like, literature-wise. Our big project for our semester that we're doing right now is we're making a student-written magazine featuring a lot of articles, stories, and drawings that are made by the students in the club. So, for example, what I have up here is something that may appear in the magazine, and it's just a short article about books and why they are very important to society right now. So, if you're interested in wanting to read and write about things that really interest you, you should come and join this club.
It's a great
opportunity. We have a lot of fun. We laugh a lot.
It's led by Machine, Ms. Harper. That's enough incentive to come to the club anyways.
And it's a great opportunity to talk about any ideas, write about really anything, any ideas you have or anything else.
And make friends. Yeah.
So it's really fun, so you should come join Creative Writing Club.
Yeah.
That sounds like such a fun club.
I love that club.
You should definitely go
yes.
check it out.
They're writing so much. Mm-hmm. Dylan's there. Creative stories. Yes.
Good time.
Amazing club.
And now it's time for words of wisdom.
All right. Wait. Titans, you've been waiting for this moment. You remember homecoming, but you want something better, something bigger. Guess what? We have it here. Roll the tapes.
The dust up. It's a farm in town, they're making that money grow. Tractors, plows with flashing lights, backing up a two-lane road. they take one last lap around. That sun up high goes down, and then it's on. Come on, girl, kick it on back. Z71 like a Cadillac. It on up, fill your cup up, let's tear it up, up, and kick the dust up.
Wow.
That looks like a good time.
That is going to be exciting. Titans prom tickets will be on sale next week. Get yours for an awesome night in the country.
Yes. And now, finally, some words of wisdom.
Words of wisdom are...
We all get angry at times. Anger can be a very appropriate response in some situations.
It can.
For example, if someone steals something from you, it would be natural and normal for you to be angry about that. The problem is that too many of us are angry too much of the time for too little reason, and we channel our anger in destructive ways. Here are some suggestions from mental health counselor Ron Potter Efron for learning new ways to deal with anger. In his book, Angry All the Time, An Emergency Guide to Anger Control, he says, take time off to stop the violence, quit trying to control others, ask, don't demand, accept differences, speak quietly, don't swear, and treat others with respect. Sounds like advice we all could all use. Wait, starting to think about, this is Maddie.
What? And, oh my, Maddie.
Yeah.
That's really awesome. That's really important. Oh my God, do you see this? It's a ransom letter. Oh my God.
Oh.
Mr. Louises has the weekly newsletter. Maddie, we gotta find him.
We gotta go.
Titans, stand for the pledge. We'll be back next week. We're gonna have to confront this man.